In recent days, San Francisco has been longing for a fuzzy friend from the Orient. This is the second letter from San Francisco Mayor London Breed to Chinese President Xi Jinping in 3 months, bidding for a partnership to host giant pandas from China. The letter came after the end of a number of Sino-US panda loan agreements, and zoos across the United States were obliged to send pandas back to their home country one after another.
And now China wants them back.
The Chinese government ready to take them back.
Voices of concern thus emerged in Western media, fearing China could halt its panda loan projects overseas. Over 20 pandas worldwide in total have been returned to China since last year. Around 50 are still abroad, 4 of which are in the US. Delighted at the homecoming of pandas, Chinese people are expressing gratitude for the devotion of foreign panda lovers. However, their emotions can be much more complicated. Last spring, Memphis Zoo announced the passing of Le Le, a 24-year-old male panda, shortly before a scheduled return to China together with its spouse, Ya Ya. Le Le was reported to have died of heart disease. Widowed and seemingly in low spirits, Ya Ya's chronic skin condition caused an uproar on social media. This also triggered voices against panda loans in China. Based on protocol, China usually loans pandas in pairs to foreign countries. Panda cubs born overseas are to be returned to China after reaching adolescence around the age of 4. The life expectancy of wild pandas is around 20 years, while those in captivity usually enjoy extended lifespans of up to 30 years. A long-term panda loan program usually lasts for a decade and can be extended to 2. It's likely that a panda will spend most of its lifetime as an expat if the program is prolonged. Thus, some in China are against sending more pandas overseas, not even to very affluent host countries such as Qatar. Jingjing and Sihai, the first resident pandas in the Middle East, are now living in an exuberant $49 million house in the city of Alcor. With advanced ventilation and climate control systems, the indoor temperature and moisture of the panda residents are well adjusted, creating a tailored environment similar to their natural habitat in China. Some argue that Sihai, since she was born, enjoys lush woods and fresh air in nature much better than staying in an artificial environment. Fun fact, giant pandas have existed on Earth for 8 million years. Known as iron eaters in ancient Chinese sources, pandas boast a super strong bite force. These Kung Fu pandas are excellent forest scouts and are capable of hiding from predators on tall trees. China's the only country with a wild panda population. However, it's not like pandas are seen everywhere in China. Until 2021, it's been listed as an endangered species.
The world's rarest animal. This is a giant panda brought from a remote jungle in mountainous
Tibet. In 1936, Ruth Harkness, an American socialite accompanied by her guide, managed to capture a panda cub named Su Lin in the mountainous western China. Later settled down in a zoo in Chicago, it soon became a media sensation. Unfortunately, Su Lin died young, not older than 2. Nevertheless, Su Lin was believed to be among the first batch of living pandas to be brought to the West. Such sad stories did not repeat too many times before China came to realize the rarity of this living fossil and crowned it as a national treasure.
On behalf of the people of the United States, I am pleased to be here and accept the precious gift of the pandas and also these other mementos from the government of the People's Republic of China.
1972 was the year of icebreaking between China and the US and of panda diplomacy. Over 50 years later, depolitizing the issue and conserving the endangered species have become the new consensus in global panda projects. Still, Chinese people display a mixed attitude towards sending more pandas to foreign countries. Why? Animal welfare is definitely the top concern. However, there's a hidden reason, the psycho-cultural concept of the root. In China, even nowadays, the root signifies one's origin, often represented by one's strong attachment to the land, to the nation. To put it simply, an unwillingness to move too far away from home. The Chinese has strong affection for pandas, a national treasure, and also a family member, just like your cat or dog. Look at these furry balls. Who can refuse them?